Hey guys, hope you are all doing well. In this tutorial, I'm going to introduce you to each one of my Procreate brushes from my custom painting set. It is a set of 10 main brushes and also comes with 12 free brushes that are fun to use. Today in this video, I will show you how to use each one of the 10 painting brushes so that you can get the most out of it if you're using the brushes or planning on getting them in future. Now let's get started with the sketch brush. The sketch brush is ideal for practice sketches and also a good option for inking and calligraphy. Here is an example. Because of its loose strokes, the sketch brush makes it easier to write, and that's what makes it ideal for calligraphy. Here is another example of a sketch done using the sketch brush. Next, we have the pen brush. It works kind of like a pen, and the strokes get narrower and pointed towards both ends. I use this brush to draw lashes mostly, and sometimes to detail hair. Thank you. The third one is the brush pen. It feels just like ink, but with a little bit of texture and gives a traditional feel. This brush can be used for manga style art and sketching as well. If you are someone who prefers their line art to have some texture. And here is an example. The next one is the pencil brush. It does what the name says, works like a pencil and gives you pencil on paper effect. Here is an example. Thank you. The next one is the details brush, my absolute favorite. This is the brush I use for my final line art. It's a versatile, pressure-sensitive brush which gives you total control. The strokes appear pale when no pressure or minimum pressure is applied and become bold when you increase the amount of pressure applied. This brush not only lets you create aesthetically pleasing sketches, but also makes it easy to apply colors and adding details to any kind of drawing. You might need to give yourself some time to get used to the details brush, but once you do, I'm very positive that you won't be able to stop using it. Here is an example of using the details brush for line art. Thank you. Next, we have the rough blending brush. It feels dry and mixes colors while leaving a rough texture, and perfect for those who prefer not so smooth blending. I use this blending brush only when I do backgrounds. This is how the blending looks like when you use the rough blending brush. When blending, be sure to adjust brush size and brush opacity as required to make the blending process more effective. The Grainy blending brush. This one is my second favorite blending brush, and as the name says, it leaves a light grainy texture. It's another blending brush I use to blend background colors. Here, I'm adjusting brightness and saturation of the skin layers. It's just a part of my process and has nothing to do with the brushes. The next one is the soft blending brush. This one is my absolute favorite from the whole set, and for blending of course. It makes your blending process a whole lot better, makes it easy and quite effective. And not only that, but it's quite satisfying to use as well. The next one is the shading brush. Shading made easy. You just need to select and paint. It will automatically make the shades darker for you. There is no need to pick a darker shade or change blend modes. Here is an example of how the brush works. The first stroke is the lightest one, and with every other stroke, the shade keeps getting darker. Lastly, we have the glowing line brush. It enables you to create glow effect in an instant. You can also use it to highlight details. Examples. First, make sure the background has a dark tone for best result. I also recommend you to use dark shades instead of light ones to paint, because that's when you can see the actual effect. For example, here you can see there is no difference when I'm using white to paint, but you can clearly see the difference when I'm using darker shades. This is what it looks like when you use a white or a close to white background color. Next, notice the difference between the actual color and the effect you get while using the glow brush. Now, I'm using the glowing line brush as detail highlighter. At last, I used the details and soft blending brush to make any modifications and changes if required. And for that, I always use new layers on top of the rest of the layers. I hope this tutorial helped you guys know my brushes better. If you have any doubts or questions, feel free to ask me in the comments or in my Facebook group.